Hi guys, this is Jason Williams, DO. This is the Williams Family Medicine Channel, helping you to live your best life. And today I wanted to visit with you about Alzheimer's dementia. Alzheimer's dementia is a debilitating disease. Unfortunately, it's in the top 10 list of causes of death in the United States. The disease has no cure. We do try medications for it, but they fail miserably, unfortunately. The pathology of Alzheimer's dementia probably starts to develop decades before symptom onset. In the United States, our population is aging. With the aging population, there will be greater and greater numbers of people affected by Alzheimer's dementia. The APOE4 allele has been studied and linked to Alzheimer's dementia. I came across a paper with the lead author, Nick Norwitz, in the journal Nutrients. This paper outlines Alzheimer's dementia proposed pathologies and then also a possible nutritional guideline or treatment protocol that theoretically might decrease risk of developing Alzheimer's dementia. I felt it to be very interesting and I wanted to share that with you. This article was published in 2021 and it is titled Precision Nutrition for Alzheimer's Prevention in APOE4 carriers. APOE4 has been extensively studied in relation to Alzheimer's. If you have one copy of APOE4, it is felt that you have 2 to 3 times risk of development of Alzheimer's dementia over the regular general population. If you have 2 copies of the APOE4 allele genetic mutation, it's felt that you likely have up to 12 times increased risk of developing Alzheimer's dementia over your lifetime. Amyloid plaque and tau tangles have been described as the pathology that's found when brain is biopsied after death. As in a lot of conditions, it's felt that the environment significantly impacts what happens in those carriers of the APOE4 gene mutation. The APOE4 gene mutation likely carries benefit in environmental exposure to other pathogens. It is found that many people in West Africa have the APOE4 gene, but yet their incidence of Alzheimer's dementia is not very high compared to that of the United States. In a study of approximately 4,000 West African people, it appeared that it mattered whether they lived in West Africa or the United States. If they lived in the United States, their risk of Alzheimer's dementia was double that of those living in West Africa. Southern Italians, when studied, also reveal similar findings. If they reside in Italy, they seem to have a very long life. If they move to the United States, their lifespan decreases significantly. And once again, these are people that all have the APOE4 allele genetic mutations. Come to America, a land of opportunity, but yet beware, stress, diet, and toxins might increase your risk for some of these chronic health problems like Alzheimer's dementia. As with many things, nutritional studies are not going to benefit large pharmaceutical industry companies. Therefore, it will be very unlikely to see large-scale studies that might demonstrate effectiveness or not in Alzheimer's dementia or other chronic health problems. In this case, we'll have to adopt more of a preventative strategy based on theory. In his article, Norwitz outlines some of the things that occur at the cellular level that might influence what happens in the Alzheimer's dementia. I don't want to belabor this, it's very technical, but I will just briefly gloss over some of these items. The APOE4 seems to affect microglia cells, and microglia cells are cells that are really functioning as immune cells, but are in the nervous system. In people that seem to have a large amount of amyloid, which is one of those features that is found in those with dementia, if they do not have amyloid plus inflammation, they seem to not exhibit the same features and the same disease patterns that others with Alzheimer's dementia have that have inflammation. Those that have inflammation and amyloid plaques seem to display the features of Alzheimer's dementia at a much higher rate than those that have amyloid plaque without inflammation. Astrocytes are cells that help to support nerve function and structure. In patients that have APOE4 genetic mutations, these astrocytes do not seem to function as well as they should and have impaired cholesterol metabolism. If you were to weigh the brain, it would comprise about 2% of your total body mass. However, 25% of your total body cholesterol is found in the brain. So cholesterol must be important for brain function. Unfortunately, ApoE4 impairs the metabolism and processing of cholesterol. Many cells in your body can produce cholesterol. One theory is that if these cells are not able to process and traffic cholesterol properly, then the cell will be tasked with the job of producing its own cholesterol, which requires energy, which can create a metabolic or energy deficit, resulting in a strain on the functioning of your brain. ApoE4 carriers also have a compromised blood-brain barrier. The cells that are supposed to keep the blood and the brain separate seem to not function as well, and then you can have decreased blood flow to areas of the brain, which can result in decreased oxygenation, decreased fuel, and resultant energy deficit as well. Insulin resistance has also been noted in many patients with Alzheimer's dementia. I've heard talk that they are considering renaming Alzheimer's as diabetes type 3 because of this. ApoE4 affected individuals tend to have hyperinsulinemia and insulin resistance. Unfortunately, hyperinsulinemia and insulin resistance also have been shown to increase amyloid plaque and tau pathology, the hallmarks of Alzheimer's dementia. Enough on the technical stuff. Norwitz presents a couple of options for treatments. Of course, this will be theoretical. You have to weigh the risk and benefit anytime you think of a medical treatment. I think the risk is very low with most of these treatments, and I think the potential upside is pretty high, therefore at least worth considering. Initially, let's talk about diet. First of all, diet that makes sense includes low carbohydrate, Mediterranean, or even ketogenic diet. All of these things can improve hyperinsulinemia and improve that facet of the metabolic state of the cells that seems to be affected in the brain that of those patients that have Alzheimer's. Without going into the exact mechanism and substances in each of these foods, I'm going to list some foods that also have been shown to be helpful in some of these cellular pathways that we have discussed. One of these is extra virgin olive oil. Vegetables including capers, red onions, arugula, Brussels sprouts, broccoli, and cauliflower also seem to be beneficial. Fatty fish and fish oil substances such as DHA-containing krill oil seem to be helpful. Limited or no alcohol seems to be beneficial. And then supplements such as B vitamins, quercetin, resveratrol, vitamin K, vitamin D, and then DHA supplements such as krill oil all seem to be potentially helpful. Alzheimer's dementia is a terrible condition, and if there's a way we can prevent this, that would be great. Once again, you will not see a large nutritional study that's funded by Big Pharma, as there's likely not a lot of financial benefit from such study. For my patients that are interested in longevity and improving quality of life and hedging their bets, I think some of these items that Norwitz presents in his paper are very low risk and of value. If you are my patient, I hope you found this interesting. If you're not my patient, you need to speak with your own physician about diagnosis and treatment. This is Jason Williams, DO. This is the Williams Family Medicine Channel, helping you to live your best life. Take care.